Greetings, this is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. My talk today focuses on the fact that I'm actually attaching a piece that's a reflection of the partnership between Freightliner, a division of Mercedes-Benz, and Tesla. Bonjour, wie geht's, здравствуйте, ni hao ma. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. So one of the biggest thrusts of my dialogue has been focused on the partnership when it comes to trucks of Mercedes as well as Tesla. Most of the material I've been referencing has been incidences where Mercedes in their information is alluding to the use of superchargers for their Fuso, Mitsubishi brand, and other products. In this article, you'll notice that after Mercedes, 1 year after Mercedes did a $50 million investment in Tesla, there's a step van division of Freightliner that evaluated the best technology available when it came to batteries and selected Tesla batteries in their partnership with Panasonic to develop their electric van concept products. I thought it was fascinating that Mercedes had been sort of working on their own to try to develop a viable solution when it came to electric short delivery vehicles. And then, you know, Freightliner, for one of their customers, was helping to deliver a product and did so. And they used Tesla batteries, and that is confirmed, as you will see. I found it interesting that ever since these partnerships were developed, the more successful Tesla has become, both they and competitors like Mercedes-Benz have become somewhat secretive about the origin or their supply chain in most cases. One of the notes that I saw that I thought was fascinating is that Mercedes actually just contracted with a smaller Korean battery manufacturer to provide batteries for their passenger vehicles. But I was really fascinated because Mercedes is actually going to be providing their own thermal control to go with the batteries that are provided by their Korean partner. I believe it's SK. And I was a little surprised by that because it really shows that Mercedes thinks that it's important to have, you know, sort of the thermal properties well managed in order to get a win. So I was kind of pleased to see a written example of the relationship between Tesla and Mercedes being articulated, especially after it was explained that the selection that was made by Mercedes had nothing to do with the other investments, or the selection by Freightliner had nothing to do with the Mercedes investment in Tesla. It was simply deemed to be the best battery solution they could find. I also find it kind of fascinating because sort of the process used for the Freightliner products in terms of an initial test and then starting to put it in with customers to see what their reaction was is exactly the same process Mercedes used in Germany when it came to testing sort of the Tesla battery packs in light-duty trucks and now in medium-duty trucks with some of their largest customers getting a chance to test out those products and figure out what they want to do from there. I'm intrigued because, you know, as we've been discussing, Mercedes and Tesla are both going to make announcements about semi-trucks coming up in September. And I'm sort of fascinated because I'm 100% confident, or 99% confident, there'll be somewhat of a joint announcement with the two partners working together to deliver customer solutions. I do think, though, that going forward, you know, the likelihood is that they end up being competitors or frenemies, and sort of this results in the unfortunate circumstance where both sides can no longer be closely aligned as they have been in the past. But I don't think it's avoidable unless the two companies merge. At any rate, this is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. Please take a look at the attached article on the Freightliner relationship with Tesla batteries, and then by extension, the parent company of Freightliner being Mercedes and their relationship with Tesla in terms of providing battery packs to enable them to provide electric solutions when it comes to trucks. Our sessions are usually longer, but I've had numerous requests from folks to sort of delineate where there's an example of the two companies working together. So I was excited to find the situation and be able to highlight it. Thank you very much for taking time out to watch once again. Have a good day. Tschüss, macht's gut. Au revoir, à tout à l'heure. And look forward to our next conversation. Have a good day.